Hello, this is a painting and it's got a bit of drawing on it as well. It's of an exploded megaship. The megaship is the Sacrosanct. The Sacrosanct was a big survey vessel megaship. It was owned by the Far God Cult, and these are a Thargoid worshipping group. And there was three megaships that they had. They had this one, the Sacrosanct, the Perdition, and the Testament. Now, they all went round and looped the bubble, basically. It got hijacked by the leader of a terrorist group. And this picture is a screenshot I took in Madrid, which is where the terrorist leader, Theta 7, took the megaship. He basically held all of the cultists inside hostage, and in the end blew the thing up, killing everybody on board and himself, we assume. Although obviously people are suspicious, because it was quite successful up until that point at keeping the authorities on their toes, giving them the slip. He escaped from a penal colony where he'd been held for being a terrorist and blowing stuff up. But unfortunately, the existence of this penal colony is denied by the people that we assume run it. See, so we don't really know how he got out. Anyway, yeah, he was called Theta 7 by the Imperial Internal Security Service. So they gave him that name as his designation when he went to Serene Harbour, the secret interrogation facility. Not long after he got out of there, that's when he really became infamous, because he bombed 9 starports and, you know, 500,000 people were killed and hundreds of thousands of people were hurt. And he was based in the Madrid system when he planned all that. So this picture is in Madrid. The greenish glow that you can see in front of that planet, it's a Thargoid enzyme cloud, because he got hold of this corrosive toxic substance, which he used in his bombs. I'm assuming initially to give the impression that it was carried out by aliens, but actually, not long after he put his hand up and said, yeah, that was us, that was. Basically, the NMLA want the Empire to be a democracy, and the Empire don't want the Empire to be a democracy. And so there are all these Marlinists who are follow Marlon Duval, who was the leader of Akinar, the first leader of Akinar, when it was a republic, before it became an empire. And Marlin's brother bumped her off, we assume, in a suspicious crash, and a brother took over. And then that's when it became an empire, and the rest is imperial history, I guess. But the Marlinists, they don't want the Empire to be a hereditary monarchy. They want it to continue to be the Republic, and the Neo-Marlinist Liberation Army that Theta 7 was involved with, they're an extreme terrorist group who were fairly keen on the idea of bumping off the Duval family, I think. I quite like the way that the megaship's coming apart and you've got these flames coming out of it. I don't really think it's quite finished as it finally ends up looking on this picture. There's a few wonky lines that need tidying, and there's a few missing windows, and there's the odd plume of smoke that's not there. But I quite liked using the chalk on top of the paint on the canvas and then putting the watercolour pen on top of the chalk and blending it all together. It actually worked a lot more easily and allowed me to make it a bit more detailed. This is the first actually smashed up megaship I've seen in the game. It was really amazing sight to see when you go to the system and you drop and you just see the bits of twisted, melted metal floating in space, and the smoke. It's dead good. I hope they do more of it, especially if it's a starport that you're used to travelling to. If they did this sort of thing with an Ocellus, and it was your home or part of your trade route or your faction that you play for was suddenly ripped out of its home system and left to perhaps in some way petition or gather resources to build a new starport. Wouldn't that be cool? I like that the game makes you think like that. Anyway, this is done. Thank you for listening and watching. Bye.